Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com with an update on the Dejounte Murray trade front, as well as a little bit more on the potential for the Lakers to trade for Tyus Jones. Before I dive into it, quick reminder, do subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell as well. That way you are up to date on all things trade related. We're going to be making sure that we cover everything going on with the Lakers on the trade front all the way up until February 8th, which is the trade deadline. All right, so Michael Scotto from Hoopsype had this to say about the trade situation. Said that the Lakers have been arguably the team most linked to Murray due to his representation at Clutch Sports, the agency for the various Lakers, of course, LeBron James and Anthony Davis, most notably. Said any framework for a Murray trade to the Lakers would involve guard D'Angelo Russell, league sources said, and that Russell would have to be flipped to a third team because the Hawks don't want to run the risk of D'Angelo Russell picking up his $18.69 million player option for next season because they don't think he's a fit with Trae Young. So in order for the Lakers to get Dejounte Murray, this would need to be a three-team trade, sending D'Angelo Russell to a third team and stuff going back to the Hawks. That complicates things. Oftentimes, the saying around the NBA is that three-team deals are where trades go to die. It's very difficult to pull off a three-team deal, though not impossible. We certainly see them happen all the time. In fact, we just saw one happen yesterday in the Pascal Siakam deal, although New Orleans was a very, very, very minor team involved in that process. But just to pause for a moment, the Lakers' 2029 first-round pick would have to be included. So far, what Scotto is reporting here is stuff that goes along with what I've been hearing as well. Number one, that D'Angelo Russell would be the guy to be traded, that is the player the Lakers are looking to move here at the trade deadline. That goes along with what I've been hearing, that's the name, that's the guy that the Lakers continue to look to deal. And again, that's coming off of a 29-point performance in last night's win. Does that dissuade the Lakers to some degree? The Lakers also won't wait forever for the Hawks to figure out whether or not they're going to trade Dejounte Murray to them. So that's the other thing. When we talk about Tyus Jones, who I'm going to get into in a minute, when we look at Colin Sexton, these are other options for the Lakers. And I think a way to make sure the Hawks know, hey, look, we're not waiting around all the way up until the buzzer for you guys to figure out what you want to do with Dejounte Murray. If you want to get something done, needs to be done sooner rather than later. Moving forward, again, that 2029 first would be involved in the deal. How could the Lakers plus up their offer, considering the Hawks are reportedly wanting two first-round picks in exchange for Dejounte Murray? Certainly the 2029 first is one first-round pick. You could argue what D'Angelo Russell was worth, but Jalen Huchefino could be included, although Scotto notes that they picked Kobe Bufkin over him and probably for a reason, and JHS has not had a stellar rookie season. The Hawks did ask about Austin Reeves, according to Scotto, but were denied by the Lakers. Now, I can add on a little bit of that. I've heard that the Lakers have gone as far as to say to Austin Reeves that he is not being traded, to tell him that he is not being traded. So I think the Lakers are pretty determined to not deal Austin Reeves. Obviously, things can change between now and the trade deadline. If things were to get to a point where they got an offer that they simply couldn't turn down, I don't think Austin Reeves is the type of player that you simply don't trade, period. Like if a star suddenly becomes available or something, he's not one of the true untouchable players in the league. I mean, there's only a handful of them, right? So that's not the case, but I think they're going to do everything they can within reason to not trade Austin Reeves. And again, it's already been communicated to Reeves that they're not going to trade him. So I believe the Lakers will not trade Austin Reeves for Dejounte Murray. And instead, they will look to build a deal around D'Angelo Russell. And I think the same is going to be true if it's not Dejounte Murray, if it's other players as well. It's going to be a D'Angelo Russell-based trade. Now, over to the Tyus Jones piece of this. Scotto also noted that the Washington Wizards are looking for a first-round pick in exchange for Tyus Jones. Now, if you're the Lakers, are you flipping D'Angelo Russell in a deal like that? Probably not. I don't think that would make a lot of sense. I like Tyus Jones as a player, but I would rather keep D'Angelo Russell. So this would be something where maybe the Lakers stack up a few salaries. He's making $14 million expiring. That's Tyus Jones's contract. And then you throw in a pick. Now, would you, if I'm the Lakers, I would see if I can get it done for less than a first. I would try for a couple of seconds or something like that and see if that is a done deal. Washington certainly can ask for a first round pick right now, but honestly, I'd be a bit surprised, despite how well Jones has been shooting, if they actually get that for Jones on an expiring $14 million contract. So perfectly reasonable for Washington to say, yeah, we'll trade Tyus Jones, just give us a first. Doesn't mean other teams are actually going to bite on that, though. So that's where things currently stand. The Wizards looking for a first-round pick in exchange for Tyus Jones. I would not expect the Lakers to actually surrender that first-round pick. Dejounte Murray, obviously on a different level. Look for a deal potentially built around D'Angelo Russell. Doesn't mean it's necessarily going to happen. Again, the Hawks don't seem to be in a rush to get a deal done, and the Lakers have made it clear they're not going to wait forever for the Hawks to figure things out with Dejounte Murray. And again, already putting out there that they have other targets that they can look at in Colin Sexton, Tyus Jones, and I'm sure there's other players the Lakers are looking at as well. So certainly something that we're going to be keeping an eye on as we get closer and closer to that February 8th trade deadline. Do they get a deal done? Is it Dejounte Murray? Is it Colin Sexton, Tyus Jones, somebody else? What kind of a move do the Lakers make, or perhaps moves, as we saw last year at the trade deadline? Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. What do you want to see happen for the Lakers this year on the market? Make sure you subscribe. Don't forget to turn on those notifications as well. Till next time, stay safe and see you.